We have been running a series of convenings which are part of work we are doing on women's political participation. This is part of a consortium with partners that are supported by IDEA and the government of Sweden, but also partners from Genderlinks based in South Africa. We're also working with WILSA, with PADARE, with IFAD in Senegal, and FAWE. So this consortium came together and we are working in 7 African countries, where Kenya is one of the countries. So we've started Women in Political Participation Policy Dialogues to really look at, you know, what are the different tactics, what are the different lessons that we should be drawing together. And for Kenya in particular, because we know that in 2022 there'll be elections.
Personally, I've been mentored by different organizations to where I am today and to having been elected as an MCA. And therefore, I wish to encourage organizations like FEMNET to come out and encourage as many women as possible to come out and run for office. It's not easy for women. You can imagine if for a man is not easy, for a woman it's 10 times harder.
So today was a culmination. The first one we had with members of parliament and the National Assembly. But out of that, the county assembly, they came to us and said, as women caucus within the county assembly, we also want to have a space, a platform where we can also start engaging and also stand in solidarity and start preparing for 2022 elections.
The lessons that we have learned in the past should now be, we are now giving a baton to the other younger generation, those who are behind us, and we are ready to hold their hands. We are ready to work with them. We are asking the women to come out. Organizations like FEMNET will be willing, and they have confirmed their commitment to holding women's hands so that we can start this process of preparing them for 2022.
As FEMNET, we are supporting the women to meet together, to have a space, even just a space for healing, a space for bonding, but a space to show solidarity for each other, and a space to also make declarations and say, we want to push for more women to be in decision making. We want to push for more women to be elected in the coming elections.
Your meeting here today will mean a lot in terms of how you move forward, but most importantly, that it will impact on your work as women in the county assembly who has a responsibility, noting that by now, I believe you know your mandates and what you need to do.
But even beyond looking just for elections, it's also what sort of challenges are women facing, women who are in leadership right now with the COVID-19 pandemic. How can they, within their county assemblies, national governments, within their constituencies, how can they also have an impact? How can they have an equal say in decision making and be on the table in the distribution of resources?
You have heard about UWEZO Fund, regulations to deal with the Youth Enterprise Fund and the Women Enterprise Fund, because Treasury and the Ministry of Gender have preferred or formulated regulations to merge the three funds that we give to women groups. And UWEZO Fund is also in Nairobi, in the constituencies. There is a lot of money that your groups, women groups in your ward, can access. And they are not limited to MPs. All you need is to be able to see how you can mobilize groups. And the starting fund for self-help groups is 100,000. I have found that very helpful myself as a tool to be able to go to there, because you can't be able to raise 100,000 to take to one group. But if we have a fund which is ours as women, why are you women, MCs? How many of you have organized groups? Have organized groups to be able to access that money? This is money available for you that can propel you.
And we know that as women have been leading in terms of a lot of their work, how can it also be visible? And how can women be covered differently, covered positively within the media as well. So we know there are a lot of politics that are happening, but we are saying we want to push for the provisions that are in the Constitution. Can women come together, take a position, and also push for the two-thirds gender rule and say we want 50-50, we want an equal share for women to participate in Parliament. So as FEMNET, we are really working with the consortium members, also sharing the lessons across the continent. So there's a lot of cross-regional learning across the countries that we are also working with in terms of supporting women in political participation.